Presentando la esquina azul, introducing the blue corner. Vestido de rojo con negro, he steps in wearing red with black trim. He weighed in at an official 205.5 pounds. Detuvo la báscula a un peso oficial de 205 libras y media. Esta noche, dentro de la jaula, hace su debut profesional tonight. Inside of the jaula, he is making his professional debut. De Ciego de Ávila, Cuba, and now fighting out of Miami, Florida, Gustavo Trujillo. Su contrario en la esquina roja, his opponent in the red corner. Vestido de negro con blanco, he steps in wearing black with white trim. He weighed in at 204.25 pounds. Detuvo la báscula a un peso oficial de 204 libras y un cuarto. Esta noche, en su segundo combate a nivel profesional con récord de una derrota. He enters the jaula for the second time as a pro with a record of one defeat. Repping the MIA, Miami, Florida, Wesley Black Sheep Cantillo.
Fighter ready. Fighter ready. Let's fight.
The hammer.
See the Cuban Gustavo Trujillo on his back against the 40-year-old Wes Cantillo from Miami. Cantillo 0-1. Trujillo, the Cuban, making his professional debut. We're at the Manaw Wynwood in Miami, Florida. Campbell McLaren bringing us Combate Americas, Combate Clásico is what he's bringing us. La Jala is where they're at. Bethel Duran, Juliana Pena. Always cool when you see somebody making their pro debut, Juliana.
Yeah, absolutely. Gustavo Trujillo is from Cuba, and he was on the national wrestling team from Cuba, and that was actually how he made his way to America. Right now he's having a hard time with Wes Cantillo on top. He needs to improve his position, but you can tell that Wes's experience is definitely helping him out here.
Wes Cantillo, 40-year-old, nicknamed Bad Sheep. Such some decisions he had early on in his 20s. Got the tattoo, embracing it now. He's a coach and teacher at UFC gym here in Miami. Has about 70 people in attendance when they announced his name. There's a big ovation for him. There he is with a nice knee. You see his knee wrapped up with the brace. Think he has a bum knee. Didn't want to elaborate why. Just something with him. So one way to be a coach and a teacher, but you have to show your students what it's all about. That's why he's here in Combate America.
Absolutely. He is a coach at the UFC gym, and he wants his students to know that if you have a passion, go for it. He wants to set the example on when you're passionate for something, you just take it full on and don't cut the shortcuts.
The Cuban gets back to his feet, kicked by Cantillo in the black.
Wes Cantillo said that he loves the style of TJ Dillashaw, he loves the style of John Jones, and he wanted to kick the leg out, the front leg out of Gustavo Trujillo.
Weighing 205 pounds, going back to that left leg of Trujillo. Here's Cantillo.
He also said that he believes that his conditioning is what's going to set him apart, and the person with the best corner is the one who wins.
Going after those kicks is Cantillo. And again, the Cuban staying right there with him. The right landed by the Cuban, Gustavo Trujillo. He's in the red, brings down Cantillo.
There goes my favorite takedown. Double underhook body lock straight to the back.
Why is that your favorite one?
I feel like it's the very first one that you learn. You know, you get double underhooks, you bear hug, take them down. They should be able to not get away from you if you get double underhooks on them.
Protect himself is Cantillo.
At first, it wasn't going so well for Trujillo, who said that his friends work at the UFC gym in Miami, that Wes Cantillo teaches at. So he said those guys have been feeding him information about his opponent the entire fight camp, so he wasn't worried about anything that that guy brought. And now we see Wes Cantillo's in full mouth. And big, heavy punches by Gustavo Trujillo.
He's a Cuban wrestler. Going for choke. Nope. Out of it.
Nice big elbows on top.
Yeah.
And you can see how much more physically imposing Gustavo Trujillo is. He's just
Does he
huge.
Have him?
It looks underneath the chin, yeah. But he definitely didn't have the right angle.
Oh, that elbow had the right angle.
Yeah, but Wes Cantillo did a good thing. He gave up his back instead. Or he didn't. He went back to his back, excuse me. Straight arm lock here. If Gustavo can get his right back tricep like he's doing right now, glued to that right ear.
Like he's going for right now?
Exactly, that's tight.
That's the tight one, Juliana?
Yeah, he needs to make him paint the mat a little bit more, though.
No, it's out of it.
Nice job by Wes Cantillo.
30 seconds ago in the opening round. Scheduled for three. It's 3 5-minute rounds.
And this is what I would do if I was him, too. Clearly, you don't, you know, you're not utilizing getting out of mount that well. So I would suck onto him, not let him get any punches off, and wait for the 15, 10 seconds to go by so that you can get back to your feet in the next round.
Just hold on right now.
Yeah, right now that's his best bet.
You hear the clap. Final seconds of the opening round. A good one between Wes Cantillo and Gustavo Trujillo, the heavyweight, coming in at 205 pounds.
Yeah, normally walking around at 230.
National wrestling team, not the Dominican and defected, left, and then basically got on a raft and took off.
Yeah, he went to American territory over there, claimed refugee status, jumped on the second raft out of three. The first raft sank, everyone died. The second one, everyone made it, and the third one sank, everyone died. So he says, thank God that he was on that second raft, because he made it and he's able to, you know, make money. He wants to make money so that he can bring his mom here to the United States, and it's a much better life over here than he had in Cuba. And he said, they don't really know too much about MMA in Cuba. They're kind of unfamiliar with it. But he trains at American Top Team in Kendall. And clearly, his work has been paying off, especially with his wrestling pedigree that he has.
He knows Yoel Romero, Jorge Masvidal.
Those are some of his training partners. Yoel Romero is one of his heroes.
In Cuba, he used to get those bootleg videos. That's what opened his eyes to the sport of MMA. That's what he came to the United States to fight MMA specifically. That was his intention. Here he is in his pro debut.
Yeah, they're not allowed to have those MMA fights over there in Cuba. So someone illegally downloads it on a zip drive, and they go from door to door selling all the fights uploaded on a zip drive for $1, $2. And that's where he learned about MMA and how he saw a lot of fights.
On top is Trujillo the Cuban.
Trujillo is doing a great job. I'd like to see a little bit more ground and pound from him. Meanwhile, Wes Cantillo, this is not a resting position. You need to donkey kick that side leg out. You need to get back to your feet. Use the cage to help you stand up. Oh, he tried to donkey kick there, but it wasn't quite right. He needs to get to his feet, hips out, turn into his opponent. Use the cage as your friend. Use it. Use the cage to help you get back to your feet. He needs to turn into him. He can't turtle shell up like this. If he keeps going like this, it's just going to be a matter of time before the guy just starts raining down with even more heavy blows.
Greco-Roman was the specialty for Gustavo Trujillo when it was the Cuban wrestling team. Wes Cantillo, single, 40 years old, at the UFC gym in Miami. Big dude. All these guys are big dudes.
Yep. He's making his Combate America's debut. And actually, he started out as a personal trainer. And he was a trainer for top welterweight Jorge Masvidal for a long time, who actually introduced him to mixed martial arts.
That's right. He was training Masvidal. And in turn, Masvidal will teach him martial arts. Here he is now in his second professional fight. He's 0-1. It's Cantillo, the former football player at Palmetto High in the Miami area.
Yeah, you can tell that he doesn't want none. You know, he's kind of turtling up in a turtle shell. I'd like to see Gustavo use his hamstrings more. There we go. Flatten him out and then just start raining. Don't go for the choke. Just start punching, you know. He's being a little too nice in there. But it looks like he's going to give him what he wants. Because
and he just heard you dropping a couple elbows.
Yeah.
So right there, you would just say attack, attack?
I would say punch, punch. Punch with the left hand. You need to be raining down punches as hard as you can to that side ear. Just ear holding. Ear hole until it curls up, excuse me, in the fetal position, like much like he's been doing for this second round. less than 90 seconds left in the second round, he doesn't want it. He wants out of there. And especially at 40 years old with that big, you know, 24-year-old guy on top of you, they should stop the fight soon because, you know, covering up like that is not fighting back.
There's some blood on the face of Cantillo. Cuban dad, Costa Rican mom. Off of that choke. Oh, there's a gash of blood. Oh, that's over the right eye. Oh, he is pouring out blood.
You know, and once you see your own blood like that, it kind of gets into your head.
Another elbow, and that's it. It's over. Fight is done. Second round victory for El Cubano Gustavo Trujillo.
It kind of looked like he was talking to him right before he threw that last elbow, like he was saying something right before Gustavo threw that last elbow. That was crazy.
Damas y caballeros, una serie de golpes obliga al referee Michael Cardoso a parar la contienda con un tiempo oficial de 4 minutos 18 segundos del segundo episodio. Ladies and gentlemen, a series of blows forces referee Michael Cardoso to call a halt to this contest with an official time of 4 minutes 18 seconds of round number 2. The winner in his pro debut, el vencedor en su debut profesional, Gustavo Trujillo.
El Cubano Gustavo Trujillo, professional debut.